I see Almiron making a good run. Big chance. Cut back for Tammy Abraham. Has to be a goal. Let's go. We get the equalizer. Tammy Abraham. And what lovely football that indeed was. I see Ferran Torres once again making that run. He's broken through. Ferran Torres goes for goal. He scored a second, guys. And now, on aggregate, we're going through. This is it, guys. We could be at the end of the road with Newcastle United. This could possibly be the finale of this Newcastle series. The 40-odd episodes we've done in this series, and the journey could be coming to an end. And we've got the chance to end off this series in the best way possible as we take on Manchester City in the Champions League final. This is going to be epic. We've got a chance to take Newcastle right to the very top of Europe. And let's not forget, we've also got a big chance of winning the Premier League in this episode itself. In fact, we win our next game, which by the way is against Arsenal. That's it. It's done. We'll be champions of England. We've got a real chance of completing the double this season. It's honestly been such a fun journey with Newcastle all these episodes. You guys have enjoyed this series so much. I have as well. In this episode, we're going to wrap up the Premier League, Champions League final, end of season awards. We'll take a look at all the stats of our players for the season and series. A lot to look forward to. And also, let's not forget, we're going to discuss about my next career mode a little bit. Now, if you guys have enjoyed the vibe of this Newcastle series or even have watched a single episode, I'd really appreciate if you could smash a like on what could be the final episode of this series. If we can smash out, let's say 5,000 likes, that'll be really, really awesome. If you are new around here, subscribe for daily FIFA 21 career mode content. There is still more to come, even if we wrap up this Newcastle series. For now, let's get into business. Final press conferences, Newcastle boss. This is getting a bit emotional now. Your next career mode should be a Dortmund one. They're struggling in real life, and it would be fun to see the likes of Sancho and Haaland together. Honestly, man, Borussia Dortmund, that would be a super fun career mode to do. I feel like with them not making Champions League football for next season, I think it'd be a great series, I'm not gonna lie. Yeah, they're doing okay in the Champions League, but overall, Dortmund, I think we've got a job to do. They're trying to topple Bayern Munich's dominance. Yo, that is definitely a series I want to get into. So, next career mode, I'm saying it now, is going to be Borussia Dortmund. I already announced this in a way on stream on Twitch. If you guys want to check out my Twitch, links will be in the description. But yep, a couple of seasons next with Dortmund will be awesome. If we wrap up the Newcastle series today, expect to see the Dortmund career mode begin probably this Friday, okay? So, a few days of gap. We'll have other videos to cover that, but I'm excited, man, even after the Newcastle series. Next up, the reason why Ferran Torres was doing well against Man United is because he was at CAM. Will you play Torres at CAM more? Now, because Ferran Torres was so good against Man United in that CAM spot, literally, he overturned the scoreline on his own to send us through to that Champions League final. I'm in confusion. Do I start him at CAM or stick with Joe Willock, who's been amazing in that position for so long? So it's a bit of a confusing one. We can of course play Willock in a bit of a deeper role and Ferran Torres at CAM. That's what I did against Man United and it worked wonderfully, but that is a bit risky when you're going up against top opposition. So it's put me in a big dilemma. We'll have to see. And probably in the Premier League, I might use Ferran Torres at CAM and see how that works and then make the call for that big Champions League final. But yeah, Torres at CAM was a different animal. Next up, I feel like this Newcastle career mode is one of the best ones you've ever had. I really enjoyed how you took a team filled with decent players, brought in solid signings and developed them and make this team worthy of a Champions League. I mean, we've not won it yet, but we're there in the final. I absolutely agree with you, man. This has been one of my best career modes I think I've done on YouTube with all the kit stuff we involved, you know, changing sponsors. And it was just a superb story, you know, with Tammy Abraham reviving his career at a different English club. We signed players like Willock for cheap on a loan to Bayern, just developed him into an amazing player. Calvin Phillips leading the team, Fabian Schär being there from day one, even though he was aging. It was phenomenal. Of course, the saga of Saint-Maximin going up to a 90. This series had it all, some amazing moments, and it's been one of my favorite career modes, if not my best career mode yet, and I completely agree with that. Hopefully, you guys in the comments section have enjoyed this series as well. And that's it, man, for the final press conference. Time to get into business, because we've got a Premier League and Champions League waiting for us. With that, wrapping up the final press conference. Zero doubts about who's winning player of the episode this time around. Ferran Torres with a masterclass against Manchester United to send us through to the final, and he wins the player of the episode award. Looking at the league table, the Premier League definitely feels like it's in the bag. We're on 88 points now, 8 clear of Liverpool, All we need is one win, or even a couple of draws, and that's it. We'll be champions of England. Yeah, we can make it happen now. We're playing Arsenal. I would love to do it against Arsenal. That'd be really fitting. Newcastle versus Arsenal up next. We win, we'll be champions of England. Now, we just had that game against Manchester United, and because of that, a lot of players were low on stamina, particularly our wingers. So I've decided, you know, to accommodate having no wingers for now. We're going to be running a 4-1-2-1-2 narrow. It's a very effective formation. And for the first time in this series, you guys are going to get to see Abraham and Callum Wilson up top together, so that should be a lot of fun. Willock starts, Longstaff as well. I've had to bench Shah. He was super low on stamina, but he's on the bench, so he'll be involved in potential title celebrations. But that's our team, guys. We win this, we are champions of England. Let's wrap this up so we can focus on the big one, the Champions League. Let's get this done. It's really fitting how we've got an Alan Shearer Tifo in the background as well for this one. Let's do it, man. Let's do it for him. It is Arsenal versus Newcastle. We're playing at St. James's Park. Who would have thought we'd be in a situation where we can win the Prem with Newcastle in just three seasons? But here we are. Let's freaking make it happen right now. Oh, that's a good challenge from Calvin Phillips. Here he goes. Here he goes. A bit of movement from someone. Oh, there's the movement from Joe Willock. Still Joe Willock. Opening up that space. Going for that finesse shot. Forcing a big save from Leno. From the first minute itself, we're attacking. We want to wrap up the Premier League in this game itself. We're not taking any chances. Let's see if we can get something from a set piece. Longstaff putting it for Tammy Abraham, who attacked it really well. Goes down inside the box though. But it is going to be offside. Oh well. Corner coming in. Martinelli whipping it in and almost getting the goal for Arsenal. There was a good block from one of our players and Pepe gets caught offside, I think. But, ooh, that was intense. So far, I think we've been the better team. But Arsenal have got a few chances in them, so we got to be careful. Here goes Max Adams with this formation. This is something you're going to see a fair bit as I look for the cross for Tammy Abraham. That was not the best of volleys. I don't know what he was even trying there. But he gets it back because he keeps trying, man. Tammy Abraham does not give up. Looking to open up a bit of space here. Go on, Tammy. I see space out wide for Arons. I'm going to find him. All right. We'll look inside for Longstaff. Ah, that's given away cheaply. Oh, Martinelli looking for that pass inside. Good challenge from Wesley Fofana. Big night for him in the absence of Fabian Shah. As Willock is now driving us forward. Looks for Abraham. Back for Willock. I think he's through. I think Joe Willock is through. Has to score. No way has Leno saved that. I could have maybe squared it for Callum Wilson, but I thought I would mess up the pass. How on earth is Leno saved that? Unbelievable. We should be 1-0 up. Maybe something we can do from a set piece. Tammy Abraham looking to attack it. Somehow we get a shot off by Tomori. But, well, that's why you shouldn't shoot with Tomori. Problems, yes. Nicola Pepe has gone through. Nicola Pepe scores and we're 1-0 down to Arsenal. The celebrations could be cut short here by the looks of things. Arsenal make it 1-0. Oh, God. Oh, God. I don't want to lose this. I want to wrap up the Premier League in this one at the St. James's Park. Just stupid play from us to concede that. Frustrating, man. That's his 15th goal in the Prem, by the way. Fair play. Half-time, and it's been definitely a frustrating game. The fact that Arsenal play that five at the back, man, it's so difficult to break them down. I think I'm going to make some changes for the rest of this game. I really feel like we need the star players for this one. Saint-Maximin to come on. We'll bring on Ferran Torres for Longstaff, and that is how we're going to run things, guys. Super aggressive now. We're going for it. We are absolutely going for it. In fact, I'm thinking we bring on Shah for Fofana, and that's how we're going to run things, guys. We're going for the Premier League title now. Looks for Tolisso. Ferran Torres out wide. Back inside for Tolisso. Now it's Saint-Maximin. Looks for Willock. Big chance here. Joe Willock against his former team. Turn, shoots. Oh, brilliantly done. Joe Willock scoring against Arsenal and showing a bit of respect against them. Makes it 1-1. I told you, man, the changes we've made, super aggressive. We're trying to win the Premier League tonight itself at St. James's Park. Brilliant play between between Saint-Maximin and Joe Willock. Joe Willock with a lovely couple of touches. The finish was superb to open up this space. We're back in it, guys. Let's now push for the winner. So frustrating, guys, to have dropped points against Arsenal. I think we'll still win the Premier League regardless, but we could have won it tonight, dudes. We really could have. I'm gutted, man. This was supposed to be our title celebrations game, but oh well. It is what it is, I guess. It is what it is. Let's see the league table and see what's up. Okay, now. So it's a 6-point advantage we have against Liverpool with 2 games to go. Imagine if we bottle from here, guys. Our remaining games are against Villa And who was it against? Leeds United. So I'm not expecting to bottle. What I'm going to do, I guess, is we'll do the visual sim on the Aston Villa game. And towards the end, we'll jump in and, of course, see out the celebrations. Because I feel like against Villa, we're gonna get the job done, guys. No worries. But yeah, Liverpool just keeping the pressure at us towards the end as well. All right, guys, it's time to play Aston Villa, a game where we can win the Premier League. Let's wrap it up this time, legit. So we're going to do the visual sim towards the end. I'll jump in and try and sort things out, you know, to watch the celebrations and all, because I want to witness us winning that Premier League title. So as long as it's a draw, it is enough for us to win the title, guys. So yep, let's get it done. Yo, guys, we've made it 1-0 against Aston Villa. Who else but Saint-Maximin to score? That should sort things out pretty nicely for us. I don't see Villa making a comeback. Let's get to the end and enjoy the celebrations. It's so fitting that it's Callum Wilson who scores the second of the night to give us the title. It's done, guys. Let's jump in, see out the game, and of course, enjoy the celebrations after. And that's it. It's done. We are champions of England. Newcastle have just won the Premier League. We're getting the celebrations as well. We've done it, guys. I know it's been difficult. Liverpool fought with us or against us till the end, but we were just too good this season. Everything fell perfectly into place this time around. Champions of England, boys. Champions of England. What a season. Tammy Abraham hopefully will finish as top scorer in the Premier League. I'm just hoping, but overall, it's been incredible, man. We've taken this team to the very top of English football. The Premier League trophy after so long. Come on. Time for the trophy celebrations. Fabian Schär, our captain, to walk and pick up the Premier League trophy. Fitting, man. It's fitting. We've now added the Premier League as well to our trophy cabinet. So successful this series has been. Over three seasons, we've won the FA Cup twice, the Community Shield twice, and now we're adding a Premier League trophy to it as well. Absolutely incredible, guys. Fabian Schär lifts the trophy. Unbelievable. And as I just said, we've added the Premier League trophy to our cabinet. So I just simulated our final Premier League game of the season and we've lost 2-0. I don't know how this happened. Look at our shots and all. That's a bit painful, but ultimately doesn't matter. Ferran Torres did pick up an injury, so that's something I am worried about. But with that, the Premier League is done. Let's quickly take a look and see if Ferran Torres' injury is serious. I really don't want him missing that final, especially with him being in good form. Pulled hamstring, will be out for the next 10 days. Okay. Will he miss the final? He might just about make it for that final. Very interesting. But guys, that is how the final Premier League table looks like. We're top of the Premier League, 92 points. We've won it with a 3-point advantage over Liverpool. We're champions of England, man. Liverpool, City, United complete the top four. Who are the teams that have been relegated? Leeds, Southampton and Watford going down. Very interesting, but what a season, man. We scored 79 goals. Man City scored way more than us with 94, but ultimately our defense was the best in the league, courtesy of Fabian Schär. What a season he had. 24 goals conceded. Incredible. Things you do love to see. Tammy Abraham wins the Premier League Golden Boot. Probably the first Newcastle player since Alan Shearer to make this happen. 28 goals, one more than Bruno Fernandes. What an achievement. Assist-wise, we had Saint-Maximin competing in the top, but De Bruyne just about edged him out. Clean sheets, Nick Pope, 22 clean sheets this season. That's more than 50% of the games. Incredible from Nick Pope. What a season. For now, though, it is time to play possibly our final game of the series as we take on Manchester City in the Champions League final. This is it. The series could end if we get the job done here and are crowned champions of Europe. Let's make it happen, man. We've won the Premier League. Let's win the Champions League as well. Man City are a very dangerous team to come up against, guys. We know that. Look at the team they've got. Bernardo Silva. Ander Herrera in midfield is an interesting one. Aguero, of course. Sterling, Laporte. A very good Man City team. And the final is being played at the Bernabeu, by the way. So that's going to be epic. Looking at our team, Abraham starts. I'm not risking Ferran Torres. He's not fully fit, so I'm going to be playing Almiron instead. But at some point, Ferran Torres will be brought on as a sub. Don't you worry about it. But the rest of our team, pretty much the strongest 11 I can put forward. This is it, guys. This is where we can make this Newcastle career mode the best ever by winning the Champions League right now at the end of Season 3. Let's freaking do it. This is what it all comes down to, guys. 3 seasons of hard work, around about 40 episodes, and we're here. Champions League final. Time to wrap things up with Newcastle. Here we go. Tolisso opening up that space. An early goal could be just absolutely vital as Abraham finds Saint-Maximin brilliantly. I tried to curl it in, didn't work, but Tammy Abraham still gets it. Oh, there's the turn. Open space, shoots and scores. Tammy Abraham within 8 minutes has made it 1-0 against Manchester City. His 11th in the Champions League. We get the early goal in the Champions League final. Unbelievable bit of skill from Tammy Abraham to score that, the Elastico. And then the finish with the left foot. It was right in the roof of the net. There was no chance of the keeper saving that. 1-0 up. We've got just the start we needed. It's time to build on this and defend like we're meant to be champions. Come on. We go again. Manchester City looking exposed in these early few minutes as Saint-Maximin breaks through. Could be an early cross maybe for Tammy Abraham, cleared away by Laporte. Oh, and by the way, this looks like a different Herrera. It's probably not under Herrera, guys. I guess I shouldn't be surprised. Under Herrera would never play for Man City. Anyways, we're on the breakaway again. Abraham looks for Willock. From distance, goes for goal. That's a good save from Edison. Uh-oh, Aguero could be through on goal. We need to defend this. Calvin Phillips, no way. How has he let Bernardo through? Calvin Phillips had him covered. How did he let him go through? Not that way, guys. Not that way. Bernardo Silva scores. Just awful, man. Absolutely awful defending. I could have stopped him right there. I should have maybe gone with the sliding challenge or something. But look at that, guys. Calvin Phillips was ahead of Bernardo. How did he not win that challenge? Just stupid, man. And it's 1-1. I'm going to have to take it backwards, but it's working well as I see so much space on the other side. But Bernardo Silva tracking back as well. What a performance so far from him. Oh, it's Bernardo Silva again. Problems for us. Conde is trying to mark him. But Bernardo Silva is so silky smooth on the ball. Still Bernardo taking it wide though and playing it backwards. Problems for us. He gets it back. Is he off? No, he isn't. The play continues as Manchester City holding on to possession. Phillips does really well there and we get it away and maybe a breakthrough now. Go on, Willock. Need to find that run from Tammy Abraham. Abraham is through again. 1v1. Can he score? He absolutely can. Tammy Abraham does not miss in games like this. Newcastle 2, Man City 1. It's been an electric game, an electric Champions League final. And Tammy Abraham, of course it's him who stepped up. Just keeps scoring goals. That's what, his 12th goal in the Champions League now. Just unbelievable, guys. Tammy Abraham with the goal. We're leading now 2-1 against City. Yeah, brilliant half for us, guys. Awesome stuff. Half time, and it's been a very, very difficult game against City. We've had our chances. We've taken them. We're 2-1 up, but City are still looking strong. Second half, it's going to decide everything. Okay, now look what we have here, guys. A free kick from about 25 yards, maybe. Who's the best free kick taker in the team right now? Definitely, it's not Saint-Maximin, so Tolisso by the looks of it. No, Fabian Schär is pretty good with free kicks, so why not take this one with him and try and get this up and under. Imagine he scores in a game like this. Fabian Schär tested the keeper, but not enough to score. He's had a decent game so far. Still Miguel Almiron taking it wide. The Cruyff turn. Willock. Saint-Maximin. Backwards for Tolisso. We're just keeping possession really well now. Tolisso again. Out wide for Max Ahrens. Cross back in. Decent delivery. Willock attacking it, but not enough. We're keeping possession really well against a team like City, and that's something that makes me proud. Could be something here for De Bruyne. Fabian Schär with a strong challenge. We've got to not give City any space to do their magic. And so far, defensively, it's working. We made that one mistake in the first half, and that cost us. Let's not do it again, especially with just 10 minutes left in this game. Oh, De Bruyne wins that. De Bruyne wins that. Good challenge on him. Conde, they still have the ball. Maybe I committed a foul, but thankfully the ref played advantage and we move. 82 minutes, guys. Just 8 minutes to go and we can wrap things up. I see a run being made by Abraham. That was a bit audacious. It still worked though. Tammy Abraham, oh, we give it away cheaply. Maximin again. Looks for Tolisso. Sees Tammy Abraham. There's the run. Looks to bring it inside. Tammy Abraham, by the way, is on a hat-trick in a Champions League final, but Edison denies him that. That's probably the last attack of this game. The celebrations could be wild, guys. We're going to try and maybe score on our final corner of the game. Probably not going to happen. Referee, just blow the whistle. End the game. We've done it, guys. We've won the Champions League with Newcastle. I simply cannot believe it, man. Just 3 seasons, we've managed to do the impossible. The Premier League and the Champions League this season. We've completed the double. Who else but Tammy Abraham to score a brace and guide us to this trophy? What a season it's been, and what a way to wrap up this series. Honestly, wouldn't have it any better, guys. Tammy Abraham stepped up in the final again for us as we win the Champions League. And it's time for Fabian Schär to lift another trophy, and this time it's the big one, the Champions League. Newcastle United are champions of Europe. Unbelievable, boys. What an episode it's been. This team we've built, man, honestly, it's one of my favorite career mode teams. There's so many cult heroes in here, like Calvin Phillips has been amazing. Fabian Schär, probably the biggest cult hero. We all know about Tammy Abraham. Willock as well. Remember how he displaced Buendia from the team? Saint-Maximin again. Gucci gang. Of course, Longstaff. This one, Sean Longstaff scored probably one of the most important goals in this series in that FA Cup final. The first one, the winner, which was a banger, by the way. So, yeah, this series has had so many amazing moments, guys. I've absolutely enjoyed it. And this team is just nuts. Let's now take a look at the stats of our players for the entire season, and then we'll wrap things up with the end of season awards. Okay, this should be fun. So it is Tammy Abraham finishing as our top goal scorer with 42 goals in 50 games. Incredible. 17 assists as well. Saint-Maximin also. Wow, what are those stats? 22 goals and 18 assists. But I feel like he was a lot better last season in comparison, guys. He was great, but I feel like he was a lot better last season for us. Maybe the fact that, you know, the transfer rumor is hanging on his head, I don't know. Ferran Torres with a decent season, 14 goals and 4 assists, but I think a few of those stats come from his time at City. Joe Willock, big season for him, 12 and 13. Tolisso with 6-7, Wilson with 5-4. Fabian Schär from defender having a good bit of goal contribution as well. But there you go, those are our stats for the season. Now before we wrap things up, we've got the end of season awards ceremony. Let's kick things off. The first category is going to be best transfer of not just this season, but the entire series, because we're wrapping things up today. So makes sense to do it this way. The two nominees are going to be, of course, Tammy Abraham, who we signed for 30 million early on in the series, I think in the second season, and what a signing he's been. But the second one is also a close contender, Joe Willock, on a loan to buy deal for 10 million. That was so cheap, and look at the output he's given us, guys. Just nuts. So it's between the two of them. Let me know who you think has been our best transfer. Next up is goal of the season. First, take a quick look at the two goals nominated and then make your decision. Here goes Saint-Maximin, all from literally moments away from conceding. Saint-Maximin with the cross. Abraham, oh my god, that's, I hate to say it, but I've got to say it. Potential goal of the season contender. Unreal from Tammy Abraham. What a volley. Releases this one for Saint-Maximin, and straight away from a Real Madrid corner, we might have an opportunity. Saint-Maximin brings it inside, goes for that finesse shot. Oh my god! Saint-Maximin, what? How's he done that? Literally from an impossible angle, Alan Saint-Maximin, take a bow. That is just absurdly good. How did he even pull that off, guys? The third category we've got is best player for this season. Yep, our player of the season. And no surprises at all, Tammy Abraham gets in on the nominations along with Fabian Schär. It was super close with Saint-Maximin and Schär, but I just feel like his leadership at the back and how good he was defensively and our record in the Premier League, we needed to have a defender in there, and who else but Fabian Schär. So it's between him and Abraham. It's a lot closer than you think. Let me know who you think deserves player of the season. And finally, to honor our best player from this entire series, including all the players from season one, your nominees for that will be Tammy Abraham again and Saint-Maximin. We can't forget how good Saint-Maximin was from the start in this series. So many big moments, so many big goals. And it's between the two for player of the entire series. Make your call. Let me know your thoughts on all this in the comment section below. With that, guys, it is time to wrap up the Newcastle United career mode. What a memorable series this has been, man. I've absolutely enjoyed my time recording these episodes for you guys. Your support's been incredible, as I asked. 5,000 likes for the final episode would be really emotional. Let's hope we can get there. But that's it for the journey. We wrap this series up with 2 FA Cups, 2 Community Shields, a Premier League and a Champions League in 3 seasons. We've absolutely gone above and beyond with Newcastle. Next up, Borussia Dortmund. Cannot wait for that series, man, Friday. But for now, this is where we wrap things up with Newcastle. If you've enjoyed this series, drop a like, subscribe, and I'll catch you all next time. Thank you for watching and supporting this series.